We are joined now by GoodRx co-founder and co-CEO Doug Hirsch to discuss also ahead of President Biden addressing U.S. prescription drug prices at 11:15 a.m. Eastern this morning. So we got a lot to get to, Doug. It's great to have you back on the show. On the heels of those earnings, certainly reporting record revenue, record profit, record users, but the fact that COVID still seems to be an issue, a headwind, if you will, walk us through that and what you expect that to evolve into over the coming months.
First and foremost, I'm so proud of what we've been able to do to help Americans with this COVID pandemic. You know, we built this incredible vaccine fighter. We more recently rolled out a vaccine passport so that we can help Americans to be able to show their vaccination status when necessary. Honestly, it was a headwind for us. I think we're really at the end of that in the terms that, as you said, we had record revenue, record profit. Almost 20 million people a month are using our product, especially also doctors and prescribers. We have over 400,000 doctors now distributing GoodRx content. Like, the momentum is huge at this company. I am so excited. The COVID is obviously a question mark for everybody, but we're feeling really good at this point that, we continue to help people with COVID and that, honestly, we're just super excited about all these new products and services that we're rolling out soon to help Americans across other pain points.
Yeah, let's talk about some of those products and services, because certainly I think a lot of folks know GoodRx is the place to go to shop around on prices for prescriptions. But what are some of these other offerings? How do they expand your portfolio and your possible, I guess, revenue streams?
Sure. I mean, so first and foremost, we have GoodRx Gold, our subscription product. And I'm very proud to announce that, Rite Aid is now a part of GoodRx Gold, making it that much more valuable. And all of those thousands of Rite Aid pharmacies are part of Gold. We also announced partnerships this quarter with DoorDash and with USAA. We're providing gold discounts to their members, which is just a whole nother constituency that can benefit from GoodRx Gold and the reduced prices that we have. A huge, huge effort we've been doing on brand drugs, where we've been working with manufacturers, and we're now working with 95% of the top 20 manufacturers who have integrations on GoodRx, where for consumers, you can find very expensive brand drugs for as low as $0 on GoodRx. And we're really proud of that. And yet it's also so small. There's so much more that we can do. So we're proud of that. Lastly, SureScripts. We've just announced a partnership with SureScripts, where SureScripts delivered 2 billion prescriptions last year. And we're now integrated into that doctor, patient to pharmacy experience.
And yet we've got President Biden, we just talked about it, speaking the next hour on prescription drug costs. It looks like something like 300 price increases from companies ranging from Pfizer to GlaxoSmithKline that have been reported. Why do we continue to see these prices inch higher, and what does that mean for your business?
We've been around for almost a decade now, and I can remember when the ACA was coming out, and then Trump had his executive orders, and now Biden has these efforts with HR3 and others. The reality for us is it has really no impact on our business. Most of the efforts you're seeing are really around a small set of very, very expensive drugs. GoodRx actually helps, and we're on the same page with that one because we're also trying to reduce costs for Americans. One of the things we really support, which I think the Biden administration is also a fan of, is more transparency and helping consumers have the tool sets that they need so they can make those smart decisions whenever they're choosing any purchase in healthcare. So I think we're on the same side, honestly, and I don't see any material impact to our business at all from what we see out there, if the stuff that's put out there right now even comes to pass.
When it comes to threats to your business, Doug, some people perceive Amazon and perhaps even Walmart down the road as a threat. You said previously, I think on our air, that Amazon, is perceived to be going head to head with us, but it's not. Why isn't it?
Honestly, no competitor has had any material impact on our business in our company's history. There's a lot of talk about Amazon somehow reshaping the entire prescription world. The reality is mail remains a very, very small part of the way consumers purchase prescriptions. And it's even with the pandemic, it really didn't grow substantially and is now shrinking. I think at retail, the moves Amazon's making, literally no one has actually seen what they're doing in retail. And it doesn't actually even work within the existing model they have. So we're very confident. Our relationships with the retailers have never been stronger. Our relationships with the PBMs and insurance companies have never been stronger. We just announced a partnership with GoHealth, so we're going to be doing a lot more in insurance. I just feel very, very confident in our prospects. I'm very excited about the new things that we're doing here. And we're looking up. I feel really good about the future.